Dear friends of the Latin American Music Center, how are you? This is Gustavo Ahualli, the director of the center. Today, we have the pleasure to have a conversation with the distinguished pianist Rosa Antonelli. Rosa, how are you? Nice to see you.
Nice to see you. I'm so happy to be today with you. And I have to say, it is an honor for me to be part of this conversation with you for the Latin American Center.
How you came to live and perform in the United States of America?
My love for music, and particularly for the piano, began at a very early age. I had to say this because still today for me is magical what happened. I was at the kindergarten, and one day the music teacher played a song. Mm-hmm. And I got very surprised about the feelings that that song opened in myself, no? The feelings I had, beautiful feelings. And then I was fascinated. I came back home, and I was fascinated, and I talked to my mom, trying her to explain to me how it is possible that a fingers touching an animated object can make me feel that way.
How did you first come to have an affinity to the Latin American repertoire? Who are your favorite composers in general? And when did you decide to start exploring it?
The first experience with Latin American composers was at my home, because my mother, like you, she was an opera singer and an actress in Italy. Then at home, we have this music, and we have a lot of popular music, a lot of folklore. We have tangos all the time. That's why I decided, I was a child, and I said, Mom, I want to learn how to dance folklore. And then I became a teacher. I am a folklore teacher. And the National Conservatory, one of my professors was Angel La Sala.
Well,
who gave me this, and Guastavino.
And Maestro Guastavino as well.
For a short time. And then I learned more, you know, even La Sala gave me the five preludes, national preludes to my hand before they published. And he said, Rosa, please one day perform this piece, because I was performing already a lot. And then I did the world premiere here in Lincoln Center of those preludes.
Fantastic. I didn't know that. Wow.
Then my favorites are Ginastera, Piazzolla, Guastavino, and then the Latin American Ponce, Lecuona, Villalobos, who I learned a lot when I was in Brazil.
Fantastic. And you've basically been exposed from the very beginning to the Latin American repertoire as part of the culture you live in, of course. And of course, I guess as after you've been exposed to all those great composers, you decided to start exploring them.
Yes, it's just I have so much pleasure performing them. I love performing these composers. And then the I call the angel was Albany Records when I recorded several CDs with them. And then once the president of Albany Records said, Rosa, we want you to record a new CD, but has to be a CD with a different repertoire than the traditional. We want something different. And then I said, maybe it will be classical Argentinian composers. And then she loved it. And I record the whole CD called Esperanza, Sounds of Hope, because all these Argentinian composers were from Europe, this, from immigrants who moved to Argentina with hope for a new life, no?
Wonderful, wonderful name.
It was this, and I love the name of Sergina. I said, oh, this is the name, Esperanza Sanso Hope.
Do you have any specific teachers, pedagogues, or performers that you look for inspiration, for example?
Yes, and I'm going to tell you something very important for me. When I was in Spain, and I saw Alicia de la Rocha, one thing inspired me from her was that she always, when she performed, doesn't matter if it's in the biggest hall of the world, in the small, she always dedicated half of her program, concert, to Spanish music. And then that, you know, I said, oh, she's such a big artist, a big pianist. And then she made that decision. For me, it's not because it was Latin American music, but what inspired me from her was her decision. Mm-hmm. And she followed that decision for all her life. Then other teachers were, for example, when I studied with Alfonso Montesinos, the disciple of Claudio Arrau from Chile, wonderful. And then he always admire Latin American music in the lessons. He always enjoyed and encouraged me to do more. Then he inspired, those teachers inspire me. And performance, I love the way Nelson Freire performs the Brazilian music. I see, I have this kind of inspirations around me.
Now it comes a very important question for you, and it has to do with the release of your last CD, Bridges. Can you tell me about this CD and how and when this project was born?
Well, this CD is my favorite so far from all of them. And the idea of the CD was born in that concert I mentioned to you that it was sold out, and I mean, I have a standing ovation. It was in that concert, at the end of the concert, I performed by heart. I usually have 5, 6, 7 encores prepared in case, not because I'm going to play 6, but just to see how I feel. And in that night, I failed to perform a Nocturne by Chopin. Then at the end of the concert, when the president of Albany Records came to the Camerino, she said, oh, Rosa, I love the way you perform. You know that when you perform Chopin, I feel like you play Piazzolla and vice versa. And I said, oh, you know, I feel the same. And many people in the audience mentioned that to me. Mentioning. And then I say, I know history of music, but this made me go again and research more, no? And then I found out they confirmed these connections, that's why I call bridges, from Chopin to Piazzolla.
Is there a specific method of study you used when learning to play, and how your studies impact your ability to execute Latin American music repertoire?
In my way of approach a piece, I have like a method. I don't like to read a piece and start learning and perfecting the difficult passages, difficult phrases. I have a routine, uh-huh. Technique, no? Like every day I practice scales, arpeggios, octaves, thirds, sixths, everything that, all the elements of the technique. And then when I approach the music, I don't have to be repeating, and I am more fresh to understand what the composer wants. But like I said before, what I do, I analyze the history, the time, the composer, what happened in his personal life, what could be inspiring him for this piece. More than anything, I want to know first which one was the message that the composer wanted to deliver, the most important, what he wanted to say with this piece, what he wanted to express. In order to do that, you have to know a lot around his life.
Of course. What do you look for in planning a program of Latin American music?
First, I think in what country I am, how big the venue is, who is going to be the audience. Once I know that, according to that, in all of these choices, let's say, I think first the composers who have pieces that never were played, never were performed. Mm-hmm. I am constantly researching about this music. First, I like to do that, this piece never was performed before, I want to make it alive. I try to give to the audience a perspective of all the composers from Latin America, the wonderful composers we have.
So in other words, there's no only one way for planning a program, like in general music, right? Like, for example, if you are preparing a recital for voice and piano, and you decide the period, the composers, by the countries, by the theme, chronologically, so it's basically, it's the same, right? And it's basically what you want to portray, what you want to show. Do you have any advice for listeners of Latin American repertoire or for other performing musicians who wish to begin to explore this repertoire?
Yes, advice from my experience that the person, the listener, when this person has an affinity or feels attracted to certain popular music for certain particular country, no? Mm-hmm. To start listening more to this music and escalate it to see what the roots of this music was, and who were the composers, the classical composers who later on took, because the classical composers take the folk and the elements from the popular music.
Now I want to invite our audience to enjoy what follows, which is a selection of beautiful music that comprise presentations of our international artist Rosa Antonelli playing in different venues in the United States. I hope you have enjoyed this wonderful presentation with Rosa.
I enjoy every single second. And thank you so much for sharing my story and my music with all of you.
Thank you, Rosa. Thank you. Until next time. Have a good day. Take care now.
Thank you. Thank you.
Thank you.